بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد. So welcome back to the gems and fawaid and benefits extracted from the works of Shaykh Abdul Muhsin Al-Qāsim. May Allah preserve him. Now today's reminder is actually very, very important. Why? Because the topic itself is from the most important topics, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have reached a part of the book where the author tells us that it is obligatory upon us to know four things. From them, knowledge. And the author explains that this knowledge is knowing about Allah, His religion and His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So we are going to focus a bit more today about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now Shaykh Abdul Muhsin Al-Qāsim hafidhahullah has mentioned a few narrations of the sayings of Ibn Qayyim and also one of Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. We'll start off with the saying of Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, where Ibn Qayyim says in Madarij al-Salikin, verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has dispraised those who do not glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He should be glorified, nor do they know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as they know Him, nor do they describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He should be described. Subhanallah. And this is something very important, which is learning about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, learning Aqidah, learning Tawheed. Because through this science you learn about your Creator, the one who created you. And here, before I carry on to mention the other aqwal of what the Shaykh has mentioned, there's a point where our other Shaykh, Salih Al-Usaymi, may Allah preserve him, he mentions, which is there is a mistake in the methodology that most of us have right now when it comes to learning about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially when it comes to the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What we have made this science now is just a science of information, where we learn something just so we can refute the Ahlul Bid'ah, and without any doubt, that is part of the religion. However, it becomes a problem when we take a small part of the religion and we go so extreme into that and we forget about the rest. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا, that we have made you a middle nation. We have to be in the middle without going to the extremes. And Shaykh Usaymi mentions that the ulama in the past and the Salaf weren't like this. When you learn about how to refute the other sects, that's ilm al-furq or al-adiyan, ilm al-adiyan wal-furq. This comes later. This comparative religion and sects, this comes later. The first thing that they would learn is about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that it could have an effect on themselves and an effect on their hearts and their iman and their worships. Most of us will say, oh, we know the Jahmiyyah, they denied Asma wa Sifat, and the Mu'tazila, or the Mu'tazila denied, they affirm the names but they do not affirm the characteristics of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then the Asha'ira, they affirm the names and only seven Sifat, and so on. People will mention this. However, these people are, affirming only seven. You might say with your tongue that I affirm all of them, but in your heart and in your actions, is that really the case? When we learn that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears everything, why do we still say those words which are displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When we say Allah can see everything, why do we still do those actions which are displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When we learn about the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this should have an effect on us. And this tawheed is not found in books or in the gatherings. This is found when you are alone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How are your actions when you are alone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Has that tawheed, that aqidah, had an effect on you? And the reality is, most of us, including myself, firstly, we are very, very deficient when it comes to this. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us for our shortcomings. Hence why some of the Salaf, they would say, لَيْسَ الْعِلْمُ بِكَثْرَةِ الرِّوَايَةِ وَلَكِنَّ الْعِلْمُ al-khashyah. Knowledge is not knowing a number of narrations, but knowledge is having the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart. Hence what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran,
إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ,
that those who truly fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the ulama. Why? Because the scholars, the ulama, are the ones who know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They know what he is capable of, and they stay away from it. They know what his punishment is, they stay away. They know what the reward he has, so they go and do those acts of worship and obedience which is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we're going to mention in the following clip, inshaAllah, that Fudayl ibn Iyad, he says that a scholar is only a scholar once he acts upon that knowledge. Otherwise, until he acts upon that knowledge, he's a ignorant person. And once he acts upon it, that's when you can consider him to be a scholar. Do we act upon that knowledge? Do we truly venerate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he should be? Or do we just learn knowledge so that we may refute others? Hence why some of the Salaf would say, مَنْ كَانَ بِاللَّهِ أَعْرَفْ كَانَ مِنْهُ أَخْوَفْ وَلَعِبَادَتِهِ أَطْلَبْ وَعَنْ مَعْصِيَتِهِ أَبْعَدْ. That whoever knows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more, he will have more fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will have more worship and obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will be further away from the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our shortcomings. We'll finish off with two more statements that Shaykh mentions. Here, the first he mentions the statement of Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, which links into what we just said, that by learning about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it should have that effect in your heart. It should have that fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart. But subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most perfect. And it's so amazing that when you learn about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only do you have more fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but the opposite also. You have more love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and more longing for the reward which is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hence why the scholars, they say that you have to be between like the two wings of the bird, which is between hope and fear. Hence why Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, let's read his statement. He says in Madarij al-Salikin, مَنْ عَرَفَ اللَّهَ بِأَسْمَائِهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ وَأَفْعَالِهِ أَحَبَّهُ لَا مَحَالَهِ. Whoever knows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his names and attributes and actions will love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without any doubt. So when you learn about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only does it increase you in fear of his punishment, but it also increases you of love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it makes you long what is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the reward which is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn Qayyim also says in another place, in Sawa'iq al-Mursalah, he says, مفتاح الدعوة الإلهية معرفة الرب تعالى. The key to giving da'wah is all in knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You want to teach the people? Then you have to start off by teaching them about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because that is the key. When you have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart only, without anybody else, any of the creation, only his love, his fear, then everything else in your life becomes sound. Aqidah, like we said, is not just knowing. People think when we shout Tawheed, Tawheed, it's not just to refute those who refute those who pray to the Qubur. But Tawheed is in every action that you take. Even in Usul al-Thalatha, we're going to mention some of the ibadat. Al-Dua, Al-Khawf, Al-Raja, Al-Tawakkul, Al-Raghba, Al-Rahb, Al-Khushu', Al-Khashya, Al-Inaba, Al-Isti'ana, Al-Isti'ana. All of these, make when you make Dua, you sincerely do it only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the famous statement of when some of the Sahaba were asked about taqwa, which is similar to having fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't have time to go into the details. But they would say that it is like when they're walking on a path, on a thorny path, they will make sure that every step that they take, they're careful. And same way in life, everything that they do, they make sure that it is in accordance to what is pleasing to Allah and not that which is displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I've heard stories of people when they learn about Tawheed without even mentioning the word music, for example, to leave off music. Why? Because I have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the heart. That's the tawheed being implemented in the heart. And finally, I want to mention the statement of Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, which is found in his fatawa. And the Shaykh, he mentions that once you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala truly and you single him out in worship, this is, by the way, this is Shaykh Qasim, by the way, just before he mentions the statement, this is the greatest way of gaining happiness in this world and in the hereafter. And then he brings a statement of Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah where he says, all joy and pleasure and good time and the bliss which cannot be described, this is only in إِنَّمَا هُوَ فِي مَعْرِفَةِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَتَوْحِيدِهِ وَالْإِيمَانِ بِهِ. This is only found in knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and singling him out in worship and having iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us this true tawheed and true iman and allow us to act upon it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us beneficial knowledge. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us for our shortcomings. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.